ganun, maganda raw yun for them. Science na raw yun for them. Eh siguro, hindi naman nila na-take note kung sino yung mga scientists na dumating na. Diba? Yung sasabi kong logic na pag dumating na, nakita na, dapat doon na tayo. Hindi na tayo yung parang, ah, dumating na. Ah, sige, babalik ako sa naalala kong dati nung bago pa dumating. Diba? So, ganun kasi yung ano eh, yung utak ng ano eh. Ang tawag dyan, na ngayon, everywhere is small-minded. Utak ng maliit. Yo! Thanks so much for checking in on the Rezbt-S Podcast once again. My name is Rez. I always say that. That's just a thing I say. This is the 78th episode of the podcast. I think it's the 19th, almost going on the early 20s numbers of monologues of the monologic series. Ang ibig sabihin lang nun is, I'm outright saying that I'm doing monologues. What a monologue is someone just talking by himself. Yun lang ibig sabihin nun. Wala yung ibig sabihin, except that when you put it on the form that is called monologic, then the monologue becomes also attached with the word logic. And even in English, sorry, wala lang paligoy-ligoy pa. I just want to get into the thing of it, the meat of it. Marami kasing content creators or mga musikero, puro disclaimer na. Sawa na ako sa mga, ano eh, mga palusot, pati mga puro ma-disclaimer lang at paikot-ikot. Anyway, going back to that, I decided to call it a monologic series because, you know, aside from practicing this podcast style, a monologue, when you put logic in there, then the yung word becomes monologic, which is like one mono plus logic. So one logic. And it's hard to explain logic because I remember merong pang atang minor of philosophy that just focuses on logic. A lot of lawyers take this parang elective philosophy of logic or logic. I forget the better terms, but it's basically, you know, it's basically about how order forms and how order was discovered and how people talk about chaos and order. Of course, both sides of the coin and things that hindi basta-basta naaabot ng normal or patapon na trashy types of ways of talking. It really provides a sort of environment that is most likely attributed to academics, maybe Socratic, maybe yun nga, of the philosophical, yung all. And I remember coming back to the year 2-3 years ago when I was thinking, ba't ba sinasabi ng mga tao lagi sana all? Ano ba yung sabihin nun sana all? And it's just, I took it to myself, you know, to explain that to maybe kids that have been listening to podcasts or mga natauhan na ng matatanda na bakit nga ba sinasabi yung sana all is because my answer to that personally is we've been so bored with a lot of things, politics, technology, religion, postmodernism, and since we can't process that, a lot of that as humans, we can't process a lot of what's in the cloud, what's in the internet, we sort of translate that as boredom. So parang, di ba, ang pinakamalalaking tropes na kuha natin recently is boredom, apathy, yung kasamaan or like aware, kasamaan of awareness, kasamaan of being woke, kasamaan of like you know, the evil of that, of yung parang just everything that exists that is banal is like what the hell is that literally, diba? What the hell is that when you can't even explain it to yourself, when you even shield the young from that? And then when you even sort of decide na, oh, this thing is better than this because this thing is just the repetition or like the reiteration of something. And for example, when we see that some industries don't get any better, for example, or patterns in an industry don't get any better when we say or they say that, and it's outright talamak ng nakikita na tungkol lang naman sa pagpapabongga ng ekonomiya, yung half of the discussion of the pandemic and half of it is politics. So where is the where's the life and death there, diba? Where's the, when in fact less than 5%, you know, actually die from like the real virus. And then what's uncomfortable to say these days is actually those who die from sipon are, and I'm smiling, my face is smiling right now for the audio listeners, of course. I really respect those who actually just listen on Spotify because they know that iba pa yung sound itself than the presentation. And I really commend those types of listeners, right? We already know that 50% of the discussion sa pandemia is an economic effect of, you know, the bullying of pharma, bullying of nations towards each other. And 50% is like a politicization because, you know, no one wants to admit that natimbog yung mga fascists na gobyerno. Not just in our setting, but all over the world. Anyone who is fascist is actually na ano sila, huling-huli sila dun sa ano. So I don't want to talk about corruption because it's something that's not totally kadiri for me yung pag-usapan ng corruption, because again, you know, these are just conceptually, I think I really want to talk about big things, the big mind, and what's happening there is really sometimes we don't get to exercise na our own logic. Babalik ko lang dun mismo sa logic para malaman niyo kung paano ko tinatahi-tahi yung pagsasalita ko. Bilang magandang example na rin ng pagbe-base Tagalog is yun nga yung parang ano ba, sometimes I go too fast, you know. I don't reiterate things because naiinis yung mga, nakakainis kasi yun eh, para sa mga tulad ko yung parang nagtuturo pero, you know, then babalik mo doon para ganun, para. Although I do wanna zoom sometimes, if you get my drift. But you know, some kids are listening to this show. Some really old people are really want me to. I know for a fact that may mga listeners na nagsasabi, can you explain a bit more of that? What do you mean by this? What do you mean by that? So I always reiterate stuff, and amazingly enough, I do it in a fashion na merong some sort of degree na dumagdag na from before. So I don't just literally repeat what I said in the previous podcast, which is totally could just review rin naman. Go back in time and like figure out the quality of the previous episodes of the podcast. But then I totally just would encourage you to appreciate the new ones, of course. Kung medyo you want the contemporary version of what I'm trying to say. I bring that back to always the logic of the big mind, because in big mind, yung iniisip ng lahat collectively. So, it's usually, kung mas malaki na yung something, mas massive. Sorry for that noise. Kung mas massive na yung something, you know, the collective consciousness, for example. Usually, it's immovable. It's almost always infallible. And how we experience that now, na-experience natin yan. At kailangan natin aminin as based na nagtatagalog na malaki yung impluensya ng scientific community sa pagtatagalog. Kung di natin tatanggapin kasi yun, ibig sabihin, para na lang nalaging tayo yung Filipinong addict sa mga advertisements na wala namang katuturan. Diba? Yung parang Filipino na ang pinag-uusapan lang nila is marketing, pinag-uusapan lang nila sa Chinese is go to Sinsay. O kaya marketing ng, yung tatawag ko na nga na marketing ng tutayismo, yung alam mo yun. And I go about these terms more often than not pag pag di ako tinatamad or pag wala na ako mapag-usapan, I go about these things. And they're available also on the other podcast. But yeah, coming back to logic, I have a funny story or I have a funny confession that I do now because in our household, alam mo yun, in every household, there is what's called the COVID fatigue or like pandemic fatigue when I'm just doing this as a professional, you know, someone who just tackles what's still out there, right? Especially in our setting na kung may sisingit ko lang actually sa China, alas 100 days, isipin mo yun, sa dami ng tao sa China, 100 days na silang walang case dito, hindi magawa-gawa. Kasi ginagawang pera-pera lang yan. So, pinaglalaroan pa yung marketing ng pera-pera lang yan. And that's, whether you believe that or not, you know, if you disagree totally, then just prove it. There's a comment section down there. But yeah, I mean, that's logical to say, diba? So, ang ginagawa ko ngayon dito sa bahay, pag mayroong nananakot or, you know, sa mga tao-tao dito, anyone actually, pag may mga nananakot ng nakakatakot daw yung kesyo ganito, kesyo ganyan, kasi there's a virus outside. Tapos parang sagot ko lang lagi is, ano, sarcastically, I say, ano yun, nani? Bakit? Kasi naniwala siya sa sipon or natakot siya sa sipon or gano'n. Tapos, the setting would be, for example, sa nanay ko or sa tatay ko. May mga katwiran sila ng ganito, ng old school pananakot, tapos sasabihin ko, bakit na, o kaya, sasabihin na, alam mo yun, napakadaling sabihin para sa mga matatanda na, daming namatay sa ganyan, or daming natsugi sa ganyan. Ako naman, ang sinasagot ko, bakit naniwala, ano yun, naniwala sa sipon? Ganun. Which what I call sipon theory, diba? Na favorite ngayon ng government natin, yung, alam mo yun, lalaro ng uhog, kaya hindi muna, tititigan lang muna, you know, parang kunyari, i-discover muna ulit, diba? Ulit, yung kung ano yung laman ng uhog. So, ganun, maganda raw yun for them, science na raw yun for them. Siguro, hindi naman nila na-take note kung sino yung mga scientists na dumating na, diba? Yung sasabi kong logic na pag dumating na, nakita na, dapat doon na tayo. Hindi na tayo yung parang, dumating na. Sige, babalik ako sa naalala kong dati nung bago pa dumating. Diba? So, ganun kasi yung yung utak ng mga... Ang tawag dyan na ngayon, everywhere is small-minded people, you know. Utak ng maliit. Diba? So, yung utak ng maliit, medyo basic lang talaga. Hindi natin mapipilit, diba? Hindi natin mapipilit na kung ano yung naiintindihan natin as bilang mas... Siyempre, we work on our IQs, we work on these things, but hindi man natin mapipilit yung ibang tao na maging as... na maging kasing runong natin. Kasi nga, para sa kanila, ano pa rin sila yung na-addict na sila dun sa pagiging Filipino. And when I say pagiging Filipino, I don't mean to be really sarcastic about it, but, you know, having this sort of lifestyle, having this, you know, is like, it's because yung kinoin ko rin na 2K Pinoyism, which my lawyer best friend was like, 2K Pinoyism, alam ko yan. Or alam mo, yung pinapasa-pasa mismo, yung 2K underscore Pinoyism, yung pagiging Pinoy, pinagpapasa-pasahan lang. As if it is something based on real. But yung 2K Pinoyism marketing na pinauso ng mga dilawan of 2010s, nung medyo teenager na ako nito. Alam mo yun, yung Pinoy ako, dahil ganito, Pinoy tayo, dahil ganito, dahil daw ganyan, kasi nangyari to sa past, sabihin nito, Pinoy tayo. Lagi na lang, it just leads to Pinoyism, what I call Pinoyism. So, pagpapasapasahan na yun, gagawin na yung reason of nationalism. And what that creates is just more nationalistic insecurity that should daw explain this culture, this ano. Then 10 years of that being stuck there, puta, ma-realize mo, ihi pala yun, ihi. Diba? Yung pala yung tinatawag na dilawan, na ihi. So, what that makes them like big babies, you know, big babies without logic. So, whenever I see that people just, alam mo yun, say things out of not thinking, kasi tahimik, like I said in the previous podcast, tahimik lang ako eh. This may sound like a rant or like a, no, but this is the only time I actually speak during the day. Speak more than 5 words at a time. And speak for the betterment of, you know, for the love of the art form of long format. And my one of my strong habits right now is to really be logical about the things na ibabanat ko to maintain being sharp about my belief na kung banatan ako ng oy nakakatakot to kasi the real ano is magpapa-deliver ako ng ano eh ng pagkain, you know, because galing din naman ako sa condo life, galing din naman sa ganyan, so nami-miss ko yun, papa-deliver ng pagkain, spend a little more to have other people, you know, help them with their restaurant jobs. And now that there's now technologies for ano, to food to be delivered to you, diba? And then, of course, so whenever people don't practice this theory of mind na parang iniisip, whenever you're selfish na iniisip mo yung safety mo is para sa'yo lang, hindi mo na kinoconsider na yung iba, iniisip din naman yung safety mo. Diba? Kaya nga, ano eh, nagiging, kasi, hindi naman porket, diba? Porke. Porke ba na-acquire mo na yung logic? Porke ba na-acquire mo na yung, ano, yung talino? Hindi, ibig sabihin ba nun na ikaw lang meron nun? Hindi. Diba? Ibig sabihin, pag ginawa mo kasi yun, sabihin, ang talino para sa'yo, ang knowledge para sa'yo, kaalaman para sa'yo is a badge of honor. It's like a status thing. So you're still working from status anxiety. Diba? You're still working at knowledge to be better than others. It's not like that. Anyway, so when people act that way, ang sasabi ko, bakit masama yun? Kasi naniniwala sila sa sipon. Diba? Bakit masama maging ano, mag-mask, or bakit masama maging sumunod, diba? So, ano, kasi naniwala sila sa sipon. And it's a thought exercise that I think is nice to think about, you know? Parang yung iba, yun yung magiging, ano eh, para bang sinasabi ko na yung tukoy, kung uso nung 2010s to 2010s is yung 2K Pinoyism, yung Pinoy ako kasi ganito, blah 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 kasi Pinoy tayo, blah 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 kasi Pinoy rin siya, kahit nasa Amerika siya, eh Pinoy pa rin siya. That's 2K Pinoyism. Now it's an even more bobo version of that. Is like, I mean, just bobo in the radical na kabobohan just sense is like, blah 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 because COVID, blah 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 because pandemic, blah 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 Duterte because COVID. Alam mo yun? So that's like, that's sipon theory for me. Diba? Para sa akin, sipon theory. Sabihin, hindi ka pa lumevel up dun sa paglalaro ng luga. Diba? Yung uhog. Yung uhog pa rin yung trip mo. Matanda ka na. Sinasabi mo, matalino. Iba nga, government agent na eh. Diba? Naglalaro pa rin ng ganun. Sipon theory pa rin yung favorite. So, wala. Paano ka makikita na, ano, diba, kakaya ka, diba? Paano ka nakikita na productive ng society? So, hindi ka productive. At nangyayari sa'yo, nagiging ikaw yung tambay. Tapos ikaw yung papakainin, ikaw yung papalamunin. Kasi nga, dahil naniwala ka sa sipon. Yung sipon kasi, in-explain pa. Nag-post ako recently, ano, nagpost ako recently, sorry, hindi ako maarte, hindi ako yung parang pagkailangan ko maging masungit. Or alam mo yun, yung, you know, I've been reading a lot of, listening to a lot of Zen recently as a philosophy, Zen philosophy, diba? One of the big tenets of philosophy of Zen is not to be dualistic, wag maging parang, to understand yin-yang as a dualistic, natural, black and white thing, which is what it is, dualistic. If you're being dualistic, then you're stuck in a moral, in a black and white story, which is the past, which is everything that has existed before and is still existing and will more than likely exist even after humans die or you exhaust yourself as a human consciousness. So, diba, if you're being dualistic, edi oh, lahat na lang right and wrong, mali yan, tama to eh. Mali yan kasi tama to eh. It's almost like, dumating ka pa, diba? Dumating ka pa sa buhay ko kung ang sole purpose mo lang naman pala is maliin ako, diba? Eh kung araw-araw minamali mo lang ako, ano ka, nanay ko, alam mo yun, nanay ko lang gumagawa sa akin yun eh, diba? Parang, I'm like, kaya nga, ano eh, diba, yung mga nagko-comment dito, mag-ingat kayo, please. Kasi nga, marami na nakikinig sa akin, bulag, bingi. Yun, mga walang, ano, diba, yun, dun na lang muna, wag na yung ibang pintas. Hindi naman actually pintas yun, normal lang yun sa amin. Mga bulag, mga bingi, diba? Kunwari, nakikinig, pero tumitingin pala. O kaya, kunwari, tumitingin, pero ano pala, yung puso pala yung pinapagana. And, I think that's a good enough intro as a productivity kind of thing. Pwede mo nang gamitin yun, yung ganong tipong pananalita. Thank you so much for tuning in this Based Tagalog podcast. There's usually I make it in three parts. This is part one. We'll go into a short commercial and then we'll head over to the next parts. By the way, I just want to put this in right now that siniseryoso ko na yung pagpa-podcast. My heart is in this industry. My calling, if that's such a thing. I'm actually calling you to ano, to consider becoming an early adopter of this technology because malami dyan na content na short lang, alam mo yun, ayun natin ang short lang. Gusto natin long format. Because naka-only data naman tayo, diba? Nakakapagbilang naman tayo na hindi naman pala umaabot ng 3,000 gigabytes ang pagkonsuma ng isang podcast. Actually, when streaming, it will consume less than, especially if on your Spotify, you're consuming it from Spotify, it will consume much less. And you have to train your apps, by the way, you have to train your algorithms. You're smart people, diba? Hindi ko na kailangan Tagalugin or Artian pa yung, ano. Just train your algorithms. If you like the content, leave a like, comment, and share. And just bring it a habit para you always see and get notified whenever these things come out. Tuloy-tuloy lang yung, ano, yung Rezbt-S podcast. Because dito talaga nahuhulog yung, ano ko eh, yung logic ko. Kumbaga sa Jolens... Sa Holland, may mga hulma kung saan nahuhulog yung paikot ko eh. So, wala. Nandito na tayo. Well, nandito na ako. I'm just talking about myself. So, you know, if you study all that, really, it's really logical for me. Logical. I'm not, alam mo yun, I'm not. But, if it affects you in an emotional kind of way, ikaw yung tipong mahilig ka sa boses na nakakaantok or boses na nakakakalma, or you wanna, gusto mo yung natutulog ka, may problema ka sa buhay, diba? Kasi pinakinggan mo yung podcast na to, may problema ka tuwing gabi. Kasi pinapakinggan mo to. Pagising mo, you'll feel so much better because you can work on something, right? Segment 2. Welcome back to the Rezbt-S Podcast. My name is Rez Toledo. Hindi po ako doktor. Tapos di rin ako komedyante. Ano actually ang tawag sa akin sa colloquial world, sa Tagalog world, ang tawag sa akin, kantatero. Diba? Kung ano yung kailangan kong ikanta, kinakanta ko talaga. Isang kantatero, diba? Singer in Tagalog. Kantatero sa amin, kantatero ang tawag. Diba? Kumakanta. Kaya yung sa intro ng Based Tagalog podcast, meron dun parang linya na nilagay ko sa aking art form yung you haven't even heard me sing. So huwag ka masyado mayabang, kunyari singer ka din. Ano lang tayo, humble lang tayo. Kung ano ka, keyboard warrior ka din, humble lang din tayo kasi nga, ano din eh. Unang-una, hindi ko alam yung melody dun sa sinasabi mong pagta-type mo. Pag nag-type ka dito or nag-type ka somewhere, baka hindi ko na lang din pansinin. Unless nagpapakilala ka, obvious naman sa akin yun eh, pag nagpapakilala ka. Ganito ako, you know, I identify as an engineer, I identify as a teacher. Ako identified, misidentified as a singer. Pero yung profession ko talaga right now is to try to be a professional podcaster. So I'm really working on this channel. I'm really making it like so that people will put their ads in here. So yung mga ayoko naman na advertisement, for example, yung advertisement ng mga sipon, ayoko yan. Ayoko yung mga linis-linis, ayoko yan. Actually, in the studio, medyo I like having a lot of mess in the studio. There's clutter that really helps me. As an artist, really helps me pinpoint what I really want to say, because kumbaga yung tamang siksik, yung tamang laman inside the space, yung tamang, alam mo yun, nakakatulong yun sa kung ano yung gusto ko talagang tirisin sa pag-iisip ko. Para habang chinachani-chani ko na yung mga gusto kong pag-usapan, nagkakaroon tayo ng order, pati logic kung sa kung kailan natin tatalakayin at kung kailan natin iisipin na pwede na nating pag-usapan. You might also notice that I use a lot of rhyming words. I use a lot of, I practice a lot of the Based Tagalog as a rhyme, as a rap, as sort of something that I could flow with. It's because I literally have recorded close to maybe 10, madami na yun, 10 rappers in my music career. A lot of you have been asking around about my music career, and it's really literally just like that. You know, I think I have reached the pinnacle, the top sort of, there's only so much you can achieve in the music scene in the Philippines. You know, you could be part of a stage, part of a club, part of like sort of a cult, you know, that's how they put it. But then we are a very limited industry. We are a very humble and small community. And there's only so much you can achieve in that. Kumbaga sa kitchen, limitado pa rin yung ingredients, diba? So that's a very good analogy, a very good analogy, right? But we don't have the kitchen that's like from another country, so you can't compare industries. You can compare the music and compare the musicians. At the end of the day, magtatagalog pa rin naman kasi ako, diba? Parang, ay, Pinoy ka nga pala, ay. Or like, at the end of the day, nakatira ako sa may dito lang ako nakatira, and sometimes nang naiinis sa akin, because all their lifetime inisip nila, akala ko kasi taga Australia ka eh, diba? Parang ganyan eh, kasi naman uso rin sa alam mo kung bakit ganun, kasi naman uso sa Pilipinas yung pwede ka naman talaga mag-Australia, pwede ka naman talaga mag-America, pero kung magsuot ka sa bahay, naka-shorts lang, naka-chinelas lang. Tapos pag pumunta sa bangko, parang kala mo, taga-call center kung mag-English. You know, this very confusing reality that we experience now is why literally I had to form an inkling to, you know, study the Based Tagalog theory or present it in such a way that I had to do a podcast in order to tell people that, hey, I think kahit sa akin na lang, gusto ko ng Based Tagalog theory of everything. And it postulates that sa Tagalog, we have accepted the English tropes, we have accepted the English vocabulary, that whole lexicon, in turn, their history, English being the West. Saan pa ba galing yung English? Pero may English kasi na Filipino din talaga. Eh, English sa Pilipinas, diba? Meron yan eh. Kasi kami mga, in the span of like 200 or 400 years even, may mga Tagalog na nag-aanak ng English, diba? Hindi naman natin dinedeny yun. Actually, ang nagpapadeny sa atin nun, yung mismong Filipino, wikang Filipino. See what I did there? Wikang Filipino. Kasi yung wikang Filipino nga, is like marketing. It's like the cover language, diba? Hindi ko naman sila dinidisrespect yung mga nagturo ng Filipino. But I just literally just want to say, be able to say that, hey, 10 years of that cover language is just, you know, alam mo, saan ba ginagamit yung wikang Filipino? Sa whenever people want to get into some national way of explaining things. But I don't want that, you know. I don't want to have to explain that I'm this artful because I'm this kind of Filipino, diba? That's such a weak and trite argument, diba? Na parang ganito yung kultura ng ganito, ganito yung kultura ng ganyan. Wala eh, pangit eh. Pangit naman talaga eh. So, wala. Just get real, diba? Na parang, Mga, lahat naman ng nagtatagalog na nakausap ko, ganito magsalita. Diba? Ganito gumamit ng mga words. Ganito gumamit ng mga kung anong gusto nilang sabihin. Whether it be educational or... Let me pick that up. Wag na pala. Hindi pala importante. Whether it be educational or something that's ranty, someone who's speaking in Tagalog will always gravitate to these words, will always gravitate to a technique that, you know, na if you are open to that idea, I question as someone who wants to form a theory of everything, diba? Ano ba yung repercussion? Ano yung corollary ng pag-accept ng English words and English tropes? At hindi ba ibig sabihin nun na iba yun sa Filipino? Diba? Yung sasabi ko nga, yung one of my best friends, na-trigger daw talaga siya when I started talking about based Tagalog. Na-trigger daw talaga siya kasi it's not Tagalog-based, it's actually based Tagalog. The way I see it, diba? So yung konting bend lang na ganun, actually created for something to be discussed. Diba? And I'm aware of this. I'm aware that it's an opening, right? It's an opportunity to explore language, our own language, and our own kingdom of words in a fashion na para tayong bumabalik sa sinasabi ni Plato na there exists the world of forms where math exists as similar, as concepts exist as living things, spiritual things are actually physical. And for me, the closest idea that I relate to that is yung trending onomatopoeia. Na ano ba yung onomatopoeia, diba? Yung sasabi ko, paulit-ulit na yung onomatopoeia is something that already expresses existentially and conceptually yung meaning niya as a sound. So let me break that down, diba? Yung sound mismo ay yun na yun, diba? Onomatopoeia meaning, kunyari, when I sound like bang, boom, bap, yun na yun. A bap is a part of a beat. The boom, bap. The boom is a low part of the sound. So it could be a kick drum, ano pa ba mga palpak. Yan, onomatopoeic. Diba? Sinasabi natin ever since na yung Filipino language, yung Tagalog, yung lingwahe natin, very onomatopoeic. So kahit hindi mo alam masyado yung saan galing yung words, saan galing yung ano, kanyari, maganda example na lang yung palpak, diba? Palpak eh, diba? Pag galing mo yung word na palpak, palpak eh, diba? Palpak ka pala eh, diba? So palpak ka pala eh, diba? Palpak ka, yung palpak ka, diba? Pag sinabi mo yun, parang dun pa lang tumama na sa yung meaning kahit ka hindi mo naisipin ano ba yung palpak, is it, ano ba, lumuhod, napaluhod ba, lumugmok ba, nabunggo ba, or na hindi mo naisipin yun, 'di ba? Hindi mo isipin na bakit palpak, alam mo lang palpak, 'di ba? Yun ang yung sabihin ng onomatopoeia, right? And our language is littered with a lot of balagbag, mga ganun, nakabalandra. I'm not even sure if I say that right. Nakabalandra, 'di ba? Nakabalandra lang diyan, 'di. Yung legs mo nakabalandra lang diyan eh. Di tinitigan ko, 'di ba? Anong gagawin ko diyan? Naka-collection pa eh. and then when it's trending, for example, 'di ba? When it's trending _ onomatopoeia, when it's kind of like that na, it's sort of I'm speaking of things that is almost like code to people who read the zeitgeist very well, the spirit of the times, or the language of the spirit mismong yung hinihinga natin and I'm only able to say this because I'm new to the podcasting thing, diba? And I equate it almost to swimming and breathing and meditation. So if I'm not very, kung di masyadong nagme-make sense sa'yo, maybe review a little bit more of other podcasts. I also recommend you reviewing some interviews manahanap mo nandiyan, either with Travis or si Calbo or si sino pa ba sa kanya interview si Lopez. Ayun. So you can look for that para magka context ka lang of how I talk to people, how I really am. Alam mo, lagi din akong nagmumura, lagi rin akong makulit, and then but I'm a really curious person, right? So that's why I talk this way, and that's why I use these words just to prove, just to like enable that Based Tagalog postulate. Wala pa yung theory mismo, because I remember saying na I am doing the monologic series because may hinahanap ako na ano eh, na pagpapalagay, hypothesis, diba? Para malaman ko kung saan ko ibabase yung mismong Based Tagalog theory. And I haven't put it into writing, you know. I'm really delving a lot into sound these days. Talagang literal kung ano yung tunog. Iniisip ko, and that's why, you know, it still goes back to onomatopoeia, eh, diba? Sa philosophy, ang one of isa sa mga pinakamalakas na words na na-discover ko sa Tagalog is logos. Tagalog pala yun. Paglologos, mga kaibigan. Paglologos, yung table na to, naglologos to. Yung logos niya, yung meaning ng word niya, marmol kasi ito, marmol. So when you say marmol, when you, diba, just think of that word for a bit and let that texture sort of fill your brain. Medyo matigas, diba, marmol, marble, marbling of something. It's kind of shiny, kind of like has rock patterns in it. Actually, it looks like a small, like a flesh planet right now, this table that I'm using. So, diba, yung pagmamarmol nun is like, when you study the onomatopoeic qualities of that, yun yung sinasabi kong, when I delve into that, it's like, yung mismong tunog na yun, may sinasabi na siya, naglologos na siya. Logos is the Greek word for word, or meaning, I think. Yeah. Well, word, meaning, salita, logos yan. Isa, pare-parehas yan, diba? Kaya nga yung mga kumpanya, para maalala mo yung word na logos, para yung mga kumpanya, may sarili silang logo, diba? So, yung logo yun, logo. Kasi yun yung thing nila eh. Yun yung, hindi ka naman nakakita ng kumpanya na yung logo, walang kinalaman sa gusto nilang gawin. Diba? Like yung logo ng Starbucks, may, nakakape ba dun? May siren, diba? Kasi sa Starbucks, dun dati nauso yung na ina-attract ng Starbucks as a marketing giant of before. And this is case study. This is a usual study in business school. Diba, ina-attract nila yung sirens, yung mga may ingay, yung mga aarte, yung mga literal. Anyway, pandemic changed all that. But you get what I mean, diba? Like, another logo would be McDonald's or the logo of Jollibee, for example, diba? Yung mataba yung cheeks. E di, sige, kumain ka ng Jollibee ng 3 weeks na natin kung dito mababa yung cheeks mo, diba? May pinsan ako, ganun eh. Yung pagkain niya talaga, yung Jollibee lang. So, medyo tumaba yung cheeks niya. Anyway, so, coming back to logos, anything naglo-logos. Yung pinaka-favorite kong example nito ni Jope Guevara sa philosophy, pop philosophy yung tawag dito eh. Parang normal philosophy lang. Easy philosophy is like, naglo-logos yung pader. So, pag isipin mo, nagsasalita yung pader, may sinasabi sa'yo yung pader, sasabi niya, pader ako, huwag mo akong bungguin. I'm a brick wall the shit out of you, right? Because I'm a wall, right? The wall sort of says that to you. This chair says sort of like, this is a business chair. This is like, this is a chair where I sit to think and say things through, to get a problem and create solution. This mic is like, says to you that it as long as it functions, then that's its thing, right? Yun yung paglologos, and I really literally talk to people about that growing up. Lagi yung pinag-usapan ko yun, you know, because a lot of people, yung alam lang nila is just make money, get by, isang kahig, isang tuka. or who's mayaman, who's like this, alam mo yun, yung parang babalik ka nga dun sa ano, diba, ganyan siya mag-isip kasi mayaman na siya, diba, ganyan siya mag-isip, like in the movie Parasite, diba, the rich people are nice because they're rich. So parang that logic ba, it's not complete, it's an ideology, diba, yun yung tinatawag na ideolohiya, idol, which medyo malapit sa idolon, right, because so coming from there, it's exactly because these umaga sa context ng Parasite, Bong Joon-ho, these crooks, they sort of in a way idolized, I mean, ano sila nung idolon, a dead idea of what a rich person is. So may nalaman nila na naunahan na pala sila sa ganung ano modus, 'di ba? Yung may nakatera, spoiler alert, may nakatera na pala dun sa, you get what I mean, diba? Na naunaan na sila ng, ano, na nakatira dun sa mayamang setting. So, that just hones and brings down the point of the director, si Bong Joon-ho, which is my favorite, literally, my favorite Korean. Na, this ideology is an ideology, is incomplete. It doesn't bring you anywhere closer to what the truth is, because if you start thinking that just rich people are nice, which is not necessarily the case, almost always rich people suffer a different version of what you suffer as a poor person. And then as a poor person naman, I mean, it's really literally the black and white, the dual nature of things, the dualistic. So that's why in Zen philosophy, it's not encouraged to be dualistic. Diba? If you're being dualistic towards my content or other people's podcasts or other people's content, eh, mas maganda yung video mo eh, or pangit ng video mo, ganda na gusto ko magandang audio, or this and that, diba? The dualistic nature of things. You will not find a peaceful place for you to learn. Diba? You will get stuck in that basic battle of figuring out what vocabulary is or what vocabulary you need. Hindi mo makukomprehend, hindi mo maintindihan talaga. Kasi iba yung hinahanap mo sa kung ano yung natatanggap mo. So nagiging, alam mo yun, di ba? Nagiging two-way, nagiging ganyan. Whereas, hindi ko muna ituturo yung opposite. But then, you know, this is audio-based content. So literally, I'm putting a premium on the listenership, on the act of listening. I'm literally focused on creating content, audio content, boses na masarap pakinggan, or kahit ako mismo gusto kong pakinggan to, na pagbalikan ko to 2 weeks from now or 3 weeks from now sa Spotify, sabihin ko, or sa YouTube, sabihin ko, oh, I'm much more better than that now, or hindi ko ikakahiya yung sarili kong sinabi or ginawa, because you know I'm performing at my optimal rate, diba? That's why it helps me to create small pockets of, you know, basic ideas, you know, more chunkable, alam mo yun, chunky lang, alam mo yun, hindi yung basta, hindi yung parang, ano, water flogging, kasi pag nagtuloy-tuloy ako ng monologue without a certain part, I mean, I'm really conflicted about that, and I'll probably, you know, extend for it a bit. Yung inisip ko lagi is, masyado ba akong, alam mo yun, did I go too far, or masyado ba akong, alam mo yun, I still have my insecurities as a creator, as someone. I'm not really sure eh, kung I don't really know who's listening, diba? I mean, not in the sense that I'm not denying that you are listening, or some of you guys are actually great, like wannabe are invested in listening to this. But yung sa akin lang, kumbaga, ang iniisip ko lagi, nakikinig kaya sila sa full thing, or some parts yung nakakahiya, diba? Some parts yung parang nagcha-Chinese lang ako. Diba? O nagpapatawa lang ako, o isipin ba nila na Chinese talaga ako when I talked about Based Tagalog, diba? So all this, the word for it is contempt, you know, contempt na dinadala sa, kahit sa mga katulad ko, nagkakaroon tayo ng ganyan, mga katulad nyo, nagkakaroon tayo ng ganyan. And when you have a word for it, this is what I really wanted to end this segment with, this word, this idea lang na, at least, diba, when you have a word for it, then, nakakahon mo na, yung concept, yung idea na yun, meron na siyang kahuhulugan yung logic nung pag-iisip mo na ganito. Minsan tayo kasi hindi natin inintindi mismo, hindi natin, para sabihin natin, ay, bahala na to. Bahala na, iniisip ko to, hindi ko naintindihan. Eh kung 10 years mong hindi naintindihan, that's not a very good way to go, right? You wanna be able to say that I'm thinking about this at a certain period of my time. Tagal, English, gawin natin layman's term. Iniisip ko na yan sa ganitong panahon ng, ano ko eh, ng buhay ko, diba? Nung ganito pa yung buhay ko, ganito pa yung, ano ko noon, galawan ko noon, ganyan yung pag-iisip ko. Diba? Ang tawag pala dyan ay contempt. Diba? Ang tawag pala nila. Diba? Sabihin mo nang nila pa yung nagsabi, oh. Pero, alam mo, nakasulat naman yun. Kung tawag pala dyan ay contempt. And now, at least when you know that word, yung logic ba noon, ng pag-iisip na yun, it now makes sense. May kahuhulugan na siya nung na iniisip mo, nung nararamdaman mo. So that is the nature of, I think, that's the nature that I'm more or less pointing out why an industry of podcasters exists, a community of more than 1 million podcasters now, as opposed to billions of people, right? Diba? Kaya dumadami ng dumadami, at least nagkaka-positive movement doon. Kasi nga, in playing the language game sa pagsasalita ng lingwahe or sa just pagsasalita in general, you're not gonna get the itsura, the geometry of it kung di mo rin pag-uusapan. Very tricky thing. But this is where my exploration is right now, and I hope you resonate with that. Welcome back to the show. My name is Rez. Marami ka naman pwedeng gawin eh kung nalalaman mo na na gusto mong subaybayan yung ganitong type of thing. In the previous segments, I talked about logos, logic, puro ganun da. Onomatopoeia, again. Pinag-uusapan ko yun lagi because that's you can't get past that. Eh. Wala na ibang lalampasan pa from there. But, for example, ako, I'm very grateful to have found people in the podcasts industry that almost always talk about where consciousness is fenced. And if you're not there yet, hindi mo pa iniisip yun, consider changing your language, is what I'm saying. Consider using words as what they are, diba? Hindi yung nagsasalita ka lang para igalaw lang mo lang yung dila mo. Marami kang makikita na ginagalaw lang nila yung dila nila. Saying, and this is what I'm sad about usually, diba? Saying and doing the things that they've done before, alam mo yun, ginagamit lang nila yung teknolohiya, kunwari ng pagpaparami ng subscribers para sabihin at gawin pa rin yung dati naman nalang ginagawa ng pamilya nila, dati naman nang ginagawa ng... You can't even feel that they're trying something new. They're not even getting into uncomfortable topics. And also, hindi nila ma-explain kung bakit nila tinatranslate. Di kagaya sa Based Tagalog Theory, I'm really looking out for the order of things, for example, na bakit sa pag-uusap ng mga lolo, ano man, it's almost like I will just have to concur with the idea na if it rhymes, it must be true. Diba? And sa marami na kasi akong nasulat eh, diba? Nagsusulat ako ng essays, nagsusulat ako ng libro. I try my best, you know? So, bukod sa encouraging people to do that, you know, in the Someday Dream page, it says there in the About page, ever since, write your own reality and make secure connection. So yung reality, my spaces, pati connection, diba? It alludes to some of my writing when I was younger, when I discovered Based Tagalog, or when people helped me realize my dream of becoming a songwriter. But it alludes to that na na meron pala akong madidiscover. And di, sinasabi ko yun dahil ayoko yung feeling na ako lang yun. Sinasabi ko yun kasi gusto ko yung feeling na yun, maramdaman din ng ibang tao na, and not in 20 years, not in 30 years or 15 years, I want you to experience it like right now. Like, ngayon na, ibig sabihin, pag change ko yung pagsasalita ko, and I could tell you towards the end of this how you could do that, and or just copy from other people, you know. That's how you start anyway. You copy from them. Mimesis, right? Mimesis. Ibig sabihin, Rez, ang sinasabi mo na if I change the way I speak, then I can totally transform myself. Yun ba sinasabi mo? Sinasabi mo ba, Rez, na pag... Of course, that's what I'm trying to say. That's literally the basis of learning another language. When I started converting or sort of... So the language build up the belief systems. Eh? The language build up the... Diba? Literally, man. Literally. Before, just to, before, diba, we just laugh about Tagalish or Taglish or Engalog or Taglish or Konyo. We just laugh about it, but never has it, never, no one was like, ako, for me, this is what I, okay, why do we laugh about that? Why do we laugh about Engalog? So what kung Barok this, Barok that? Eh, yung mga bata ngayon, they are becoming less Barok about it, and then, but then they are experienced in the digital native, kumbaga in the digital tropes of social media, of how we live now in the internet. Pag mas naiintindihan mo na yun, that's exactly why I wrote my book, the fiction side of it, right? Pag mas naiintindihan mo na yun, then you could resonate with why you should totally question, bakit pinagtatawanan lang yung Engalog or English ngayon? Now, and I'm like, okay, I have something I want to say, but in an artistic fashion because this is where my artistry has been leading me. So then, ang sabi ko, sa sarili ko, but then, we don't have that here. We don't have what, kumbaga, which is a sad thing, right? Na kung ano yung gusto kong nandito na sana gagawin ko nandito sa atin, kailangan ko pang aralin sa ibang ano, kailangan ko pa aralin sa ibang bansa, kailangan ko pa makita na ginagawa ng ibang tao sa ibang bansa para pa sabihin ko na gusto ko rin niyang gawin dito, kaya rin niyang gawin dito, diba? Similarly to podcasts being done, and exactly why I bring these technologies here, without sort of thinking about the cost of it. You know, the cost of it is shared by the community that understands it. Eh, yung mga tao naman na hindi naman naintindihan yung purpose ng ganito, they will never understand that. This will have no value for them. And I've experienced that, diba? I've experienced doing shit like that for this country. And not getting the reward for it, diba? And just believing that, maybe in 5 years, maybe in 3 years, it'll be worth it, you know? And the way I've been trained to get on a mind, a headspace that takes these things seriously is because I'm trained in the scientific mind. I've been trained with the scientific mind. Na hindi naman porket may problema, pagtatawanan muna, and then it'll solve itself. It's not like that. Diba? Yung iba, pinoproblema nila mismo why light exists and functions this way. And then they discovered quantum theory. Diba? Quantum mechanics. And then created lasers and trains and were able to create more or less different types of economies and industries from that. Whereas the typical, you know, people who would live here still stuck in tribalism, still stuck in the rhetoric of their religion, still stuck in the marketing of the tutayism, right? They're stuck there. They don't even like, they're just like, sige, stuck na ako dito. Diba? Masaya na ako dito. Meron naman akong kinakain eh. Tapos yung kinakain nila, you know, coming back to Bong Joon-ho, Snowpiercer, mga pangkita mo, yung kinakain nila, ayaw nilang aminin. ayaw nila aminin, diba? Yun yung kasamaan ng nare-reveal sa atin when our logic works. Only when our logic works. When your logic works, yun yung mararamdaman mo na, ganyan nga, no? So you go like that, diba? Hindi ba dapat ganito or ganyan na lang? I don't know if that makes sense or if that's still abstract, pero sa akin buong-buo na yun eh, because I that's a base Tagalog thing now. That's a base instead of calling things original just for marketing purposes, I just call it based, like really grounded, really kumbaga, ito yung reality ko eh. Ito yung reality mo eh, if you resonate with that, diba? This might be the reality of your children, of your daughters, right? Or your anak. Diba? Yun yung reality na di nila ma-explain. Eh. Ba't nila i-explain sa sarili nila? Eh, ikaw nga mismo, hindi mo ma-explain sa sarili mo. Eh. Sinong gagawa nun, diba? Ganun lang na pag-iisip ba? It's a professional thing. It could be a professional thing, and I'm really... Again, so, maybe to prove the application of that, it's obvious, no? It's obvious na people are looking at podcasts as an industry. You know, it's one way to not just regulate your emotions, not just survive the neuroticism of social media, but also to get yourself on a sort of a space galawan, yung itatawag kong space galawan. Kasi you need to have a good space in order to, and space in a metaphysical sense, right? Space na, you know, yung lahat ng tao dyan, halos katulad mo mag-isip, mag-trumip. Hindi ko naman ito magagawa kung yung trip ng mga tao ang nakikinig sa akin is bastusin ako or exploit yung mga babaeng nakikinig sa akin or hanapin ko sino yung mga lalaking nakikinig sa akin. It's not like that. I've worked so hard, years upon years, to train my algorithm to just appear towards, you know, to people who can resonate with that. Another sad fact about this is, or me, is I've only really interacted with 0.03% of people who are aware of Someday Dream, of my existence, of the project's existence. Kumbaga, although this has existed for the longest time, those who are aware about this is just part of the 0.03% bubble. And that's a result of how I trained the algorithm, diba? How I owned up to the fact that this is the content that deserved to be digested by the top, you know? Because why would I create dog food, diba? Why would I give cat food to people, right? Why would I spread junk food, right? How can I be appreciated if I do low-level rants, right? If I do low-level sort of, if I'm not being contemporary, if I'm not being just, ayoko sabihin yung now eh, because it reminds me of Buddhism, present, that kind of thing. I just want to be contemporary, alam mo yun? I've competed with a lot of even in my, some of you have been asking about my career. I've competed with a lot of my contemporaries, literally, and I remember them. It's because, they find out that Rez is this guy who likes gear. If he finds out about a new thing, he wants his hands on it, right? Because... You know, I kind of want to live a quintessential life. I kind of want to live a very modern, contemporary life. And if I could see for a fact that, oh, even the old people are getting stuck in podcasts, and I want in on that, right? Even the older people that I follow and I almost idolize and I look up to, yun na lang. Yung mga taong I look up to sa mundo, as a cosmopolitan, they get freaking stuck in podcast. And nakikita ko mismo, namumroblema sila eh. Pinasok na nila yung podcasting eh. Namumroblema sila eh. I wanted to feel that, you know, I wanted to, and I felt that, right? I felt that on my spine. I felt that in my brain and in my heart, right? I won't get there. Yeah, kumbaga, diba, if you want a sort of, sasabi ko kasi, ano to eh, this is the segment, or the, I mean, for the recording sake, this is the part where I really talk about how I feel about podcasts and having listeners and having, it's just that. I mean, if you don't value it, diba, that's why you don't, that's why I realize that people don't value this, because, you know, they just look at it, but they don't listen at it. Alam naman nila na pinapakinggan yung podcast, tapos ang gagawin nila, tinitingnan. Parang ganun, diba? O kaya, so that's the dual nature, diba? But some people aren't, diba? Some people, or even most people, are not past that. Hindi pa sila lumalampas dun sa dualistic nature, right? So they cannot achieve their zen. They cannot achieve their philosophical baseline, right? Yung sana all, hindi talaga nila hinahanap yun. Sinasabi lang nila yun. Sinasabi nyo lang yun, sana all. Kapatid ko, ganun. May mga kapatid ako, ganun. Babae, lalaki, or anong, even matatanda, diba? Or actually, diba, parang yung mga tatanda, wala naman silang nagawa pag nagsana all na yung, ano, parang. Kaya nga yung ganun ko ngayon is, oh, bakit? Kasi naniwala ka sa sipon? O di maniwala ka sa sipon? Diba? Pati ba naman pala sipon? Kailangan pa palang aralin yung belief sa sipon? Kailangan mo nalaman ba yun? Diba? And, you know, wala. Yun lang. Yun lang naman yung gusto kong, ano eh, gusto kong iparating and gusto kong malagay sa recording. It's not out of angst, it's not out of anything. It's, to be honest, I'm sad about it. You know, it's a burden that I put on my shoulder. It's a responsibility that I've learned to accept, because there's not a lot of people really here that are past that na. And I've experienced going past that through my other career, which is being a producer, diba? Or being someone who's deep into the practice of recording industry. So if in the back of your head you're asking, ano nangyayari kay, ano nangyayari sa tao na yan? Diba dati singer lang siya? Nah, it's because I went from 2012 trying to be a singer, trying to revolutionize the music industry, really, you know, sending out essays to executives, sending out essays and being more of like an example to these types of people, even in other industries, diba? Sasabi ko nga minsan pag may naiingit sa akin sa advertising industry, why does Rez Toledo just get to do whatever else he likes, or why is he, how can it that he could be so passionate and expressive with what he does, and then tayo, nandito lang tayo working for this sort of loser agency that just put out Filipino ads that people will freaking skip anyway. It's because you haven't been looking at the purpose of things. You haven't been looking at life the way I do. You haven't been looking at life the way that, alam mo yun, that is beyond economizing from it. Diba? Of course, yayaman ka sa buhay. Of course, meron kang mapagkakakitaan. Diba? Of course. Diba? Magtrabaho ka lang sa tatay mo. Magagawin niya na yan for you. Eh, bati ba kayo ng tatay niyo? Diba? Maliliit na bagay, kailangan mo isolve, and get up onto, kumbaga, there's two parts of a ladder. One, and then this, meron pa yung ledges. Diba? May steps pa. I'm not saying I've reached the top, or like I'm going back down or whatever. I'm not totally up, down, left, right about it. But in a sense, I'm just saying na the way that I've discovered, the way I am now is out of action, out of the way, out of really being lucid, right? Lucid, not in the sense na, you know, I talk about this sometimes, you know, being a lucid dreamer and all, and the power of being a lucid dreamer, right? But, and if you're a lucid dreamer, you totally get what I mean already. I'm pretty much sure na, alam mo yun, just watch a little Nolan or, you know, you totally get what I mean. If you're not lucid, then you don't most likely you don't even know what lucid means, diba? Well, you're not in control. You're not, kumbaga, that's a step off. As, mas ano yun eh, mas magandang term yun kesa sa pagiging woke or pagiging marunong. Marunong ka nga, di ka naman lucid, diba? O marunong ka nga, sunod-sunuran ka naman pala sa, ano, sa gusto ng, kunyari, diba, yung gobyerno, gusto ng gobyerno, kung ako yung gobyerno, sabihin ko, ah, gusto ko magreklamo lang na magreklamo yung mga tao tungkol sa current pandemya. Eh di, ano tayo, mag-alaskahan tayo sa understanding natin sa pandemya. And then some people, which is sad, diba, never na sila malampas dun, yung parang psych war nun. O sige, dyan na lang din tayo. Tapos peperahan na nila yan, diba? Benta na sila ng masks, yung blue, yung white, diba? Hindi man nakakatulong yun eh. Mas malit pa yung virus dun eh. Pumapa. Actually, yung virus airborne. Yun yung design yung sinasabi. Kasi, ano eh, parang inisip ng mga tao, after 20 years, ano, yung sipon, iba na raw yung itsura ng sipon. Hindi, parehas lang yung itsura ng sipon. Parehas lang, nabago lang yung tawag, tapos nilagyan ng novel, which means novel, right? I wanna end with what I recently learned from studying a podcast or listening to podcasts and brain plasticity articles and, you know, podcasts. Free knowledge about these things. That what really helps us out is novelty. Kung ano yung bago, right? So if you're like me, mahilig ka mag-aral, mahilig ka, you know, you look at broad things, you look at color, you look at art, you look at like drama, psyche, you know, industry, economics, whatever. Kung ano man yung tinitingnan, no, you're only bored because you think you know everything. But when you don't know everything, the more you are open towards accepting just what is, right? And sometimes, what you may have realized recently, or kasi 2021 eh, what you may have realized is like, novelty is the shit. Masakit man sa isipin, diba? But yung pagbabago, I think, is novelty. Pagbabago is like, always just fresh. Just like, and I realize having the human condition and thinking about and dahil iniisip ko yung ano ba, paano ko ba tatagalugin yung human condition, yung pagiging, kumbaga, yung pagiging tao, yung karakter ng pagiging tao, yung or even the well-being, yung masabi ko na isa akong Tagalog na tao na nagtatagalog na sa magandang kalagayan, paano ko ba sasabihin yun, express, i-record, and then be able to say na ano, lucid ako. So, in asking that, masabi ko na, ah, alam ko na. Tapos yung alam ko is tama and scientific and empirical. Pwede apply sa ibang tao. What are those? Ano yun? Diba? So, these things is, these things are the things that I put in this container. Kung mag-container lang naman yung podcast eh, of these, which are important things and good things that we don't see, diba? We don't, usually we don't even discuss, we don't see the being discussed, diba? Parang minsan nagiging tabu pa, diba? Nagiging bawal pa. So makikita mo, kung ano yung nakikita mo, yung kutob mo, mas malamang, kung nakakapag-isip ka naman na, matalino ka na, sabi mo, matalino ka na eh. Alam mo na nga eh, sana all eh, diba? So, meron yung ano eh, parang, two sides of the coin always. And when you start seeing the other side of the coin, you realize, you know, you get what you want. And there's ways for the world to work for you, but merong kapalit. Alright? I want to end with that because I feel so profound. I feel so profound doing that, and this is sobrang pangit na ano ko. Sobrang pangit ng language natin. Sobrang kulang. Sobrang ba't pa natin kailangan explain? Alam mo ba yung feeling na ganun? Never ba kaya na, ba't di na lang kailangan, ba't di na mag-end sa ganun or like that? Maybe it's because of the monologue, maybe it's because I'm really that expressive, or I'm totally, I don't have a cap on my honesty right now when it comes to thinking about that. But yeah. Anyway, this is for me as well as for you, and I'm gonna review it. And so I thank you, and I always end with this grateful note. Salamat. This is available on Spotify also, and YouTube also, and Facebook. Watch those apps. Again, thank you so much sa mga nag-like, share, nag-comment. Ano yun, appreciate ko very much. And also the algorithm eats that data up, diba? So kunyari, you kind of want to rock my algorithm. Subukan natin, paglaruan natin. Be consistent with it as well. And I'll see you guys on the Facebook group if you like. But also, my IG is somedaydream.og without the vowels, somedydrm.og. So get on that if you're on that app as well. And then feel free to send me a PM or two, especially if you want to contextualize it. Maraming salamat. My name is Rez Toledo, and this is the Rezbt-S Podcast Hot Hour. Rezbt-S Podcast is out. I'm out. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye, guys. Thank you.